our children's theater production. We are so excited to have them here. These are sixth graders who will be performing for you today, and I think that you are going to be a wonderful audience for them. One thing, teachers, if you haven't got this information, you will get run over right there. We need an aisle, right? If you're on the outside of the pool, you're going to be in danger a little bit. So if you guys are, Mrs. Palm, I'm worried about you a little bit. And seventh graders, thanks for staying back, because there's two places in the show that we run down the aisles, okay? So we don't want anybody to get hurt. All right. Let's pray before we get started, and then we will present our drama to you. Dear Father, we thank you for music, we thank you for dancing, we thank you for acting, and all the many ways that you've given students talents. We praise you for that. I thank you that you are our Heavenly Father and you watch out for us. And I just pray that you would help all the sixth graders to do their very best today. Thank you for this wonderful audience that could be here with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Toto, quick, into the house. you talking about?
Well, it did fall out of the sky.
It looks like my aunt built lost cow to me.
What? You're crazy. Let's get closer to look.
Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. Who are you?
Well, would you look at that? What is it?
I don't know, but she's awfully pretty.
She looks so kind.
Who are you?
We are the Munchkins!
Welcome to the land of Oz. I am the mayor of the Munchkins.
Nice to meet you.
Now, who are you?
Why, I'm Dorothy.
What's Dorothy?
I have no idea. We're so happy to meet you.
So happy.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. But where did you come from?
See, I was feeding the chickens, and a big gust of wind came, and, well...
Yes? And then she landed right here in the land of Oz.
Oz? Where is Oz?
Oz is right here in this beautiful magical land of talking trees and...
dancing flowers!
Don't forget Emerald City.
And the yellow brick road.
Us, the Munchkins!
Toto, we are definitely not in Kansas anymore. We must be somewhere over the rainbow. Well, could you tell me, please, which way is it to Kansas?
To Kansas?
Did she say Kansas?
Where's Kansas?
That's my home.
You must go see the Great Oz.
He can help you.
He lives in Emerald City.
How do I get there?
It's a long, long journey. Here are some red shoes to help you in your longer journey.
Oh, they're beautiful. But how do I get there?
Just follow the yellow brick road. Just follow the yellow brick, follow the yellow brick, follow the yellow brick road.
Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
That's the truth.
trouble. I can't make up my mind.
I don't have a brain, only straw.
How can you talk if you don't have a brain?
I don't know, but some people without brains do an awful lot of talking.
Let me get you down from here. My name is Dorothy and this is Toto. We're going to see the Wizard of Oz. Would you like to come with us?
Do you think the wizard would give you some brains?
Of course he would. What would you do if you had a brain?
Well,
not much happening.
Oh!
What?
I have a squirrel running out of my branch. That tickles!
I got a good one.
A good one? What?
A good joke. What? Okay, here goes. What kind of tree can fit in your head?
I don't know.
A palm tree. Ha ha.
How about this one? How can you tell a dogwood tree from all other trees in the forest?
I don't know.
By its bark.
Oh.
No, I don't get it.
You know, wolf is bark.
My turn. Where do baby trees go to learn?
To elementary school. Someone is coming.
Maybe it's a dogwood tree.
Huh?
I hear barking.
Dorothy and Scarecrow cautiously entered the woods. As they traveled along, they saw a sight. There stood a woodsman all made of tin. He groaned and tried to speak, but his jaws were rusty.
Why, it's a tin man, a man made of tin. What's he trying to say? I think he said oil can. Oil can what? Oh, there it is.
You poor thing.
I can talk again. Please, man or woman made out of straw. Oh, my arms. Oh, my elbows. Oh, it's so wonderful.
Does it hurt?
No, it feels so wonderful. I've been holding this axe up for ages.
What happened to you?
Well, about a year ago, I was about to chop down that tree. I was about to chop it down, and I was right in the middle of it, when it started to rain cats and dogs. I rusted ever since.
There, now you're perfect.
If you think I'm perfect, bang on my heart. Go on. It's empty. Tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart. Oh, hollow.
Empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, and yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy that shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me a balcony, a voice sings low. I hear a beat. How sweet, just to register emotion. Jealousy, devotion, and really feel a part. I could stay young and chipper, and I'd lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart.
We were just wondering if you wanted to come to Emerald City with us to see the Wizard of Oz?
The Wizard of Oz? You suppose you could give me a heart?
Of course he would!
Then yay, let's go!
Lions?
lions and tigers and bears?
Lions and tigers and bears, oh my. Lions and tigers and bears, oh my.
All right, which one of you first? Or could I take you both at once? Or with one arm tied behind my back? Or with my eyes closed?
Go away and leave us alone!
Scared, huh? Afraid, huh? Get up and fight, you shivering junkyard. Put your hands up, you lopsided back knees.
Say now, that's getting personal.
I'll get you anyway, you little pipsqueak.
Shame on you!
What did you do that for? I didn't bite it.
But you tried.
But you didn't have to hit me. Is my nose bleeding?
No, of course not. You're nothing but a big coward.
You're right. I haven't any courage at all. See these circles under my eyes? I haven't slept in weeks.
Why don't you try counting sheep?
That doesn't work. I'm afraid of them.
Oh, lion, we think you're a damn lion.
Lion, you should go see the Wizard of Oz.
That's a great idea.
Oh, yes.
Uh-huh. We're going to the wizard to ask him for a brain for me.
And a heart for me.
You could come along with us and ask the wizard for courage.
Gee, that's awfully nice of you.
Yes, and believing you see, when you're born to be a sissy without a feminine frame. But I could show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the name. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. I'd be brave as a blizzard,
I'd be gentle as a lizard,
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard, who will serve?
Then I'm sure to get a brain, a heart,
a home,
the name.
I am a pizza. eat.
And you, Scarecrow,
Want to ask for me for a brain?
Yes, Your Excellency, I mean Your Highness.
Enough. And for you, Lion. Well.
Lion! You ought to be ashamed of yourself, scaring him like that when he came for your help.
Silence, whippersnapper. I will grant your request.
What is that?
But first you must help me. Bring me www. www. You know, in another show she's got the Wicked Witch of the West.
Oh. But what if she...
Go! I said go!
The four set off wondering how they could ever do what the great Awesome has.
Oh, all right. Let's go.
lion and www.dot returned to find a very surprised Oz.
Why have you come back?
Please, sir, we've done what you told us.
We brought back www.dot.
So we'd like you to keep your promise to us. Please, sir.
Not so fast. Not so fast. I need time to think. Call back tomorrow.
Tomorrow? But I want to go home now!
Don't make me angry. I said come back tomorrow. The great and powerful Oz has spoken. Pay no attention to the person behind the curtain.
I don't believe it. You're a humbug.
Yes, I'm a humbug.
What about the brain you promised me?
And the heart you promised me.
And the courage you promised me.
Why, anybody can have a brain.
Four times, 2 times 4 is 8. A square root of 36 is 6. Oh joy, have a brain.
Tin Man. You have been so kind to Dorothy and her friends. The only thing you're missing is this.
How can I ever thank you?
Lion. You're already a hero. All you're missing is a medal. How do you feel?
Full of courage. Growl.
And for you, www.dot. Because of the kindness you have shown Dorothy and her friends, your name will no longer be www.dot, but princess.dot. Here's a wand where you may spread kindness wherever you go.
All my wishes have come true. I just feel like singing. Everybody rejoice. It feels like a brand new day.
Everybody come out, and it's the best to sing with the police.
But what about Dorothy?
Follow the yellow brick road, get on the sea, on the surf, 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 on the sea, on
bring a flirt to prepare this for you. Maybe if you see them walking around school, you can tell them good job sometime, okay? We would like to thank a few people who, without them, this wouldn't have worked. And so if I read your name, would you please come up? Miss Guyman, who designed our lion costume. For our sparkly red shoes, plus lots of other things she can have. Flowers. That man deserves flowers. He has hung us together by the